Hey guys, Vali here, and welcome back to Zero AD. And right now, I am casting a 1 versus 1 match between LetswaveaBook playing as the Britons and Lorenz playing as the Iberians. So one thing I noticed right away from LetswaveaBook is that he skipped the storehouse initially. And then took the starting straggler trees to be able to afford some earlier cavalry. Yeah, then he went and built the storehouse a little bit later. Now this I'm not the biggest fan of, you know. He already had women here in the back to build the house. Now in the range of the civic center to ensure that if the opponent does go for an all-in attack, that the house is protected, you know, the opponent can't just simply capture it and try to get you pop-capped. So yeah, that's an interesting approach of getting all this cavalry early. What I feel like he should be doing, take this, for they should already be going forward, see how much food he has. That's too much, you know, that's too much in the bank. He should be doing something with the cavalry if he trains them so early and sacrifices economy to train them so early, you know? So yeah, I feel like it's just, yeah, right, like the longer he waits, the quicker, you know, like, very suddenly, Lorenz will have done a more economy-focused start, and he will have the same amount of cavalry. That's not what, you know, like, LetswaveaBook wants. He wants to have the numbers advantage. And the war dog slowing him down too. Yeah, he's finally moving out, but I feel like could have been a bit earlier, yeah? Could have been a bit earlier. Some slingers. Ooh, does he want to kind of do a slinger backup attack, so to say. And like, if you want to also then go for a second attack with just, you know, reinforced by infantry, you do need to skip out on the barrack, because then just takes too much economy, you can't really sustain that. And yeah, see this? Like, he invested so much into cavalry so early, set back his economy and population a bit. And Lorenz, he already had more units, you know, more cavalry. Now, he did waste 2 of them. But that's not the fault of the build order, you know? That's not the fault of the build. So it worked out for, you know, LetswaveaBook here. It really did. Wait. He's getting the... Oh, he's getting the upgrade which lets you train women from houses. I don't like that. I really do not feel like that upgrade is worthwhile, you know, to get really... At least not early on in the game and you are still booming. If you can get, you know, later on to just simply enrich population cap or add some farmers later on, if you need to reboom. That's a better mistake, he didn't intend to do that most likely, he was scouting. But that worked out, yeah, he was scouting and he just again has the unit set to aggressive stance by default. And he just simply, you know, like again had that guy attacking. Could be like 2 cavalry gone too. Yeah, so that's actually really nice value from LetswaveaBook, yeah? He got, 2 cavalry from Lorenz and he got Skirmisher. That's not bad. That's not bad at all. See, I want to really see how this will work out. And like, he's already queuing up units, yeah. I wanted to say, like, he has the upgrade, but he can't afford any, you know, like, women to be trained from there. But then, well, he queued them up from the house, now he can't afford them from the civic center anyway, so... Well, I feel like he got that upgrade a little bit too early. He should most likely just send all these women just back to the civic center, get them onto farms, yeah? And just send these ones over to wood then. But yeah, he just needs everything on food in this scenario then to just kind of just at least try and sustain production. And like, he got the upgrade far too early. I guess if he had extra berries, he could sustain this a little bit better, but he didn't have any, so... It's not worthwhile. Yeah, Lorenz healing up his cavalry. He could go out, like, a simple thing he can do is just simply, you know, like, queue up 2 more cavalry. He knows he will have more numbers and he can be the one putting on pressure too. Right, getting farms, that's good. What kind of upgrade too? Yeah, I feel like I've got to start doing that a bit more too, yeah? Because I just simply tend to prioritize the barrack over the woodcutting upgrade, and then I get that woodcutting upgrade quite late.
EST?
A cavalry are on hunting duty and a barrack coming up after the woodcutting upgrade. Alright, population wise, very very even I would say overall. So let's see then how it ends up working out. Ah, that's interesting. Ah, he's building a farmstead for these deer here, yeah?
EST?
I guess the idea from LetswaveaBook is that train cavalry from the civic center, try and apply pressure with them. And then just simply train women from these houses and add them to your economy, yeah? I mean, it's interesting. It's certainly interesting. I feel like against Tiberians, that is the worst civilization to do this against because look at these walls, he cannot harass food economy. He can't harass food. So that means he has to go for wood economy. But the wood economy is the best protected area. And it will have all the soldiers, all that stuff, so. Now, like if he was Romans against whatever other civilization that's not Iberians, this could actually be quite good, you know, because spear cavalry are great at raiding. So you just, you know, keep producing more and just keep them non-stop raiding. Or at home, you know, you've got untouched food economy. And you just spam women, you know, like from there, from the houses and cavalry from the civic center and just raid. Yeah, okay, I feel like in this matchup, it just doesn't work. Like, javelin cavalry are first of all just simply worse at raiding than spear cavalry. So your raids end up more short-lived. So I guess they aren't directly as countered by spearmen, yeah? But still, it just feels like to me he's completely misplaying this. Like, this could work against, you know, like, any civilization other than the Iberians. Yeah, the Iberians, they're just insane, man. Like, aggressive strategies like this, like, what Raid wants to do, just don't work well. They just don't work well at all. But yeah, like, what for him? What he could do as well is just simply, you know, like, commit quite heavily onto cavalry. Yeah, like, it's a stable, you know.
EST?
He has 9 cavalry, but Lorenz, he has just enough to not be taken out by that. He will lose 2 more cavalry for no reason here, which obviously sucks, that is free loot for Raid. But again, like, if Raid wants to go for the woodline, well... He could try, don't think it would be something greatly successful though, right? I just get those 4s, you know, like, few hits in, right? Like, these 3 guys. They are completely separated from the rest, so you can snipe these 3. So about the extent of damage he's going for, he's just trying to get some stray units and then running away because there's not really much opportunity for more than that. And then I suppose he can also try and... good reaction time though, I didn't expect that. I just simply, again, this one guy chasing, snipe that guy, beautiful. Yeah, maybe capture this house, you know, if he keeps on chasing. Oh, these guys are split off, let's snipe them, nice. So you are really relying on the opponent kind of mismanaging his units here. Yeah, this is good idle time, this is really good. I really like this from Raid. Here, the idle time he is causing. And Lorenz. That's not correct from him to keep chasing. I did Raid see that. Yeah, that's a storehouse there. Go for this woodline, man. Go for that woodline, you know, like, I'm pretty sure he saw, you know, like, him leave a lot of soul, like, a lot of units back there, you know, check that area, maybe there's more damage to be found. Ah, well, he won't, he could have found 10 women and 8 skirmishers, that's a lot already there. Yeah, now he's producing skirmishers from the, like, the civic center too. Okay, well, in the end, I thought he could get more damage done than he actually could have, yeah? Than he actually could have. Population wise, this is actually not too bad for him. This is working out. This is working out really well, actually. This is interesting. I am really interested in this. This is something I actually kind of want to try now. You know, like get the Romans or the Macedonians. You know, the spear cavalry. And just raid. Just, you know, a bunch of different cavalry just raiding food, man. Just raiding food, and what are you going to do about it, you know? Add spearmen! I mean, we'll need a lot of spearmen to completely stop me, won't you?
Yeah, see?
Yeah, wood cutting, farming upgrades for both, yep. Yes, a few slingers too. How many women does Red House 66? You put a lot of food also floating here. Yeah, adding even more. What I feel like he should probably do is pick up loom just to be, you know, a bit more safe on the safe side. Now, Lorenz did reach phase 2. What is he going to do with that? Nothing. I feel he clicked up way too fast, didn't he? He had no reason to click up at this point in time to be phase 2. Right, because he doesn't have anyone on metal, so it's not like he can get the economy upgrades. And it's not like, you know, any of the phase 2 buildings right now will provide him with anything, you know, too useful. So yeah, for him, just add the barrack long before clicking up here and just get, you know, like 15 on each of the mines and then click up. And you can pretty soon, you know, pick up the economy upgrades, add the buildings and go to phase 3 too.
DST.
Because right now he's getting absolutely nothing from phase 2. Except having, you know, like, well, wasted 1000 resources, 500 food, 500 wood.
DST.
See, that's not great, you know, that's suboptimal, let's put it that way. I do like this, I think he's trying to make, you know, kind of a wall here, which I'm a big fan of. How many farmers is that? 9. That's quite few, man, that's quite few. Another barrack. I wouldn't have minded him, you know, like, he has all these women, right?
DST.
Add 2 stables, 2 war dogs, no? Right? I think it makes sense. You know, you've got all these women, you've got plenty of space for farm economy. It's just 2 war dogs, you don't care about them, you know, surviving or dying there, whatever. Just now mass them up. This woodline, you know, maybe his units there, still send them all in. Whatever happens, happens.
DST.
And then you've got the cavalry too, and you can just hopefully, you know, like, then cause some chaos. Could be interesting. And populations, yeah, these, they are hugely in favor of LetswaveaBook now. Like, has all these houses working, has those 2 barracks and the civic center working. He needs more farmers. He needs, you know, diesel. Farmstead. Farms. Boom, 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 boom. Okay, now Lorenz. Might me see him going forward, right? He sees those are all women. Those are all women, man. He sends all forward, right?
Yes.
He has the scouting. He has the information. If he noticed that. And I think he might have. If he noticed all those women, you'll see him going forward, I think, here. 2000 food in the bank, that's a lot. That's a lot. Okay, a market, trade that away. Oh yeah, he already has a market somewhere. Oh yeah, there it is. He'll just go to phase 3 then, I suppose. I thought he would have gone aggressive. How many soldiers does he have out here? Yeah, 40 guys, 40 soldiers. How many does LetswaveaBook have?
DST.
30. The advantage, not really too much in favor of Lorenz there, actually, yeah. So that early pressure, the cavalry, actually, you know, like, it kept Lorenz from scouting out all this huge woman spam. It kept him from scouting that, right? That worked out really well for him, actually. Now, a pretty big difference is that Lorenz will be going phase 3 before LetswaveaBook goes for phase 2. I would guess, yeah, like he's getting the second, the third building, I mean. Yeah, there it is. So after 20 seconds, he'll be clicking up. And then... yeah, well, we will see. If Lorenz doesn't trade and just, you know, raid can keep the women all around the back, all around the base, just gathering wood. You know, being safe, or he can just, you know, use these barracks to spam soldiers. He should be in a really good position here again. As long as Lorenz doesn't get raiding, this should be great for raid. I like he has gained a 50 unit advantage. I feel like a war start, yeah, and a war still like a civilization that shouldn't really be, you know. Well, they had, you know, the fast, more quickly built houses. And the Iberians, you know, had those cheaper units. Like the Iberian should have spare boom slightly, yeah? Yeah, he needs phase 2. He needs to go to phase 2, man. He seriously needs to go phase 2. He's getting gloom, which is good. Still feel like he should get like, you know, like 4 more farms here. If he's staying in phase 2 for so long, yeah?
DST?
Yeah, Lorenz is getting phase 3. And Lorenz will be phase 3 before Red even clicks to phase 2. That's completely different. Okay, military upgrades, none yet. None. He has the wood, he has the resources for them. Okay, he's getting some upgrades here, like attack. Get the pierce armor resistance upgrades. He's getting melee, which is very good. People seriously underutilize melee units, me included, I feel like at times. They quite often just overdo range. Yup, he's getting all the military upgrades, getting metal mining. Ooh. Might we see this? Champions. Looks like not. Looks like a no. Okay, interested. How will he play this then? What is his big game plan here? Oh, he went for melee attack over ranged attack too. I didn't notice that right away. Oh, he wants to do all like melee, I guess, yeah? Melee. He has... Does he want to possibly go for champions, man? I really feel like that could be quite good. He's getting more women now, isn't he? He's adding more farms, I'm pretty sure. Ah, yeah, there it is. Oh, that's the loom. I thought he had the woman from Chaos's upgrade too. Like, I do tend to do this in some 1v1s where you reach, you know, like, you're fighting, doing whatever you've got, you know, like, I need some extra farms. I don't want to produce them from my civic center, you know, I just get the house upgrade and produce these extra women I will need for farming from the houses. I feel like that's a really great way to go about it. More barracks. Population difference is just huge, man. He might feel like he's ahead, you know, but he's behind. Right, like he's so much quicker. Oh, nice, Red added all these extra farms too. He will have way better production, man. He needs to get these. Oh, there it is, he's going to phase 3 too now. Getting all the upgrades. Yeah, let's wave a book to have waste. I mean, Lorenz will have just wasted all this opportunity time he had. Nico upgrades, true actually, didn't really think about that too much, but the extra population space is just so big. Nice walls too, like his farm eco should be quite safe. Yeah, obviously, you know, champions or the cavalry show up like this house, that's the weak point, man. That's the weak point, you just capture that house, run right through. I just, you know, smell the delay to buy you some time to react. Oh, he has the population upgrade too, coming in now. 100 woodcutters, crazy stuff, man, crazy stuff. There it is, the champion upgrade is coming in. The cool, the amazing thing with Iberians. And why, their champions are insane, man, they are insane, I love them, man, they are amazing. Okay, so, two things about Iberian melee champions. First of all, he already got that upgrade. Their last attack upgrade is special, and also for the Maurians it's the same as the Iberians, yeah? It is that their swordsmen get an additional 20% damage bonus on the already now 20% damage bonus of the upgrade. So this one upgrade gives swordsmen plus 40% attack damage, so they are already now 20% stronger than all other champion swordsmen, right? And then the Iberian hero. This hero, he makes all units, I think 15% cheaper, and also trained quicker, yes, so you can have champions that are cheaper, and that are also stronger. Like, this affects all units, not just the champions, which I feel like it's just amazing, man. All those mining upgrades, since he's taking all the mines.
Yes,
so probably then expand somewhere, I guess, yeah, like a civic center soon enough.
Yes, Steve.
Oh nice, he's got this garrison. Yeah, pick updates, crenellations and sentries upgrade and you should be good. Got the tower, got the barracks right behind. I like this is great, I feel like, for him. But yeah, it's 300 population for red. It's 300. That's the big thing here.
Yeah,
it's cool, you've got the tower, but you know, he's got enough units to just absorb that damage really well. He has these farms, he has these barracks, he has all those woodcutters. I like, yeah, if they get raided, they will disappear, they can't fight back, but... Well, are they going to get raided? No. Like, most likely not raided. Comparing upgrades, difference is quite major. Lorenz wins the fight, but... His population will still be, I think, you know, not as beautiful as Red's. See, and now it will be tough for him, man. He needs more farmers, he needs more on farms, he needs more on wood. His economy just won't really hold up to Red's. Not even close. Yeah, he has his champions and they are beasts, right? But... You know, like, it's like quantity versus quality too, you know, like... The 10 champions is cool, but if they're against 50, you know, units, you know, 10 versus 50, that's not great odds. Doesn't look great no matter how strong your unit is, you know, so... It's very important to have quantity too, it's very important. Yeah, Red is in a pickle here, his army is much weaker. Yeah, that fort will go up, like Red just needs to go and get these last military upgrades here. Economy upgrade wise, he's missing woodcutting, he needs to get woodcutting too. I mean, he has all so many on wood still, but... You know, he could send a few more over to food and he just... add in those extra barracks and you should be able to just produce like crazy, man. That's some crazy production speed in. I mean, yeah, 16 units are out of the fighting here, I'm pretty sure, because they're just, you know, stuck in the towers which don't range anything.
DST?
That's a big thing, he needs a hero. I think he's doing like mostly normal swords, but at the moment. And yeah, you can see he can't really reach that 300 population mark. Well, first of all, you know, his farms, they just won't sustain that, I feel like, yeah? And also his wood economy can't really sustain that, so he needs... He needs more women for farming, he needs more soldiers on wood, and just look at this! These melee units just shred everything. Red, he has no hack armor upgrades. He has no hack armor upgrades. Again, the normal swordsmen, you know, like these guys. Oh, this guy is rank 3 though. So it's not the best look, yeah? Anyone rank 1 now? They are just beasts. Like, no hack armor upgrades. None. And the champion does 20.9 hack damage every 0.75 seconds, like... And he has all the ranged units too. He had all ranged units, right? Like, he needed some melee in there. He needed melee in there. He needed melee and he needed hack armor upgrades, man. Yeah, now he has melee, but it's too late. Alright, so... That's it, that's just how quickly it goes, man. That's just how important as well, like, in these fights, I think they had about even numbers fighting, but Lorenz had a bare army composition 1, he had bare upgrades, and champions, you know, so, while Red had so many more units, well, it didn't end up doing too much, eh? Hey, how many women is that? 118 now, he definitely had way more. Yeah, that's the thing, like, Red had so much, so many, like, he was pop-cap, but he didn't have more soldiers, that's the issue. I think as I felt like, you know, like, Yellow, he put in so much on the upgrades on the champions, he still had about even numbers to Red, and bare upgrades on Red, right, so Red didn't have the production of military to actually sustain, you know, like, proper fighting and to also... Not to outnumber the opponent. You know, this economy, I feel like you really do need to outnumber the opponent. More barracks, more all that stuff. Like, he set himself up for success, but just wasn't able to pull it through till the end, I suppose, yeah? Now the Iberians, they can't get by with weaker eco when they get the hero trained up. And they've got the stronger units too. Yeah, this was a really interesting game. This was really interesting. Economy score is about even, man. Hey, resources gathered. Yeah, look at this, man. Yellow still had stronger economy than red. Despite all those extra units, red's economy wasn't better than yellow's. At least not by much, yeah? Not by much. I feel like the difference really comes down to the fact that, you know, yellow had a lot of units just forward, trying to build, trying to do all that stuff, while red still kept more at home, you know, just collecting resources in the back there. But that's the difference, man, like extra units, they can't really make up for extra, you know, economy upgrades so well. That's really interesting, man. Resources total, count gathered, I guess, yeah? Look at this, man. Miscellaneous population. Look at this population difference. And yellow was still gathering resources faster than red. Even with red having that population advantage. Yeah, that shows you how important economy upgrades are. Yeah, bear wood gather rate, bear farm rate. That shows you the importance. Okay, I didn't even really realize that myself, but this game really highlights that. I didn't know it needed this much highlighting, you know, I always did say eco upgrades are important, but I didn't realize they were this important myself. Oh boy. Yeah, maybe, you know, I should really start doing woodcutting before barrack. Maybe that's where I've got to experiment with that a bit more, you know? That's really interesting. That is really interesting. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like, leave a comment. And also, don't be afraid to subscribe if you are new. And I'll see you all later. Peace.